There's something peaceful and tranquil about setting up my camera traps. Being out in the woods, setting up what could be a beautiful work of art, in many ways, it reminds me a lot of shooting film. You think through a scene, the lighting, the composition, it's very hands-on. It actually feels like you're creating something from nothing. Most wildlife photography nowadays seems like you just press a button and you're done. You look at the back of your camera and boom, instant gratification. Not with camera trapping. Well, how's it going, everybody? I don't know if you remember me, but my name is Neil, and I put up camera traps. It has been a long time since I've had a camera trap out. Matter of fact, the last camera trap I had deployed was the roadkill deer that we had set up for the buzzards. That was the last time I made a camera trap, and that's been several months back. And today is actually Thanksgiving, and just finished up lunch and decided, you know what, let's take a walk in the woods. And came across something that I thought would make a good camera trap, and so why not? I hadn't done it in a while. I need to get back to it. This is the best time of year, so I just set up a camera trap. And what we have here, I hope this place looks familiar to you, but this is the swamp that I've had photographed. The beavers, the foxes, the bobcats. Right here is the beaver dam. And all of this is dry. We hadn't had a good amount of rainfall in months. And so this place is all but dry. The only bit of water that's left in this swamp is right here. And it's about a foot and a half deep when it's normally about 4 foot deep. But pretty much everything else is completely dry. And I came in this afternoon just to kind of look around and see. And right here, I don't know if you can see this brown spot right here on the ground, but that is actually a deer scrape. So a buck comes in, scrapes the ground, scent marks the limb above the scrape, which he has right up here, and then urinates in the scrape. And does that are in the area will come in. They'll smell the scrape, they'll pee in there, and then when he passes back through, he can check to see if any of them are coming into heat or estrus. So I have taken some images before of a buck on a scrape in a previous video that I'll link right here. So if you can tell, the camera trap is actually right here in between these trees, and it's pointing towards the east. I'm thinking, I'm fairly positive, could be wrong, but I feel like the time that the buck's going to come in here, it's going to be twilight or in the middle of the night. That's typically when the bucks, they use this particular area. And so I'm shooting in aperture priority mode. I've got two flashes. I've got one here and then one there. So one on each side of the subject. Should light him very well from the front. And then the shutter is going to stay open for a period of time to hopefully bring in the stars at night, because we've lost pretty much all the leaves, and that's what I want. I want a buck under the stars working a scrape. All in all, it didn't take me but just a few minutes. Felt like I hadn't set one of these things up in years, but it's nice to get back out in the woods. I'm super excited. Got some ideas for the winter. The fall is almost over now. But I got some ideas for some camera traps we're going to try to set up. Like I said, the swamp is pretty much a no-go. It's all dried up, but there are some animals working on the other side of this pond that I'm getting on camera, so we'll go ahead and try to get them on camera, or the camera trap too. So, all right, so we'll check back in a week and we'll see what happens. Well, this camera trap was a bust. Put this camera up almost a month ago, and no bucks, no deer visited the scrape. We had them work around the outside that the trail camera had documented. There's a main trail right here. A few does kind of worked their way past it, but no bucks came back into the area. So this one was a bust, and we're gonna go ahead and pull it. I want to get it to a more productive location in the coming weeks. But that's unfortunate. But that happens a lot with camera trapping. You set everything up, spend a lot of time, and sometimes you don't get anything. We had a couple squirrels come across the scrape, but that was about it. So we're going to go ahead and take it out of here and move it about 200 yards on the other side of the swamp to an area where there's a lot of activity, a very heavily used trail that everything's using. I've gotten images or videos of foxes and squirrels and deer using this one trail. So we're gonna move it over there, hopefully put it on something a little bit more productive. So again, kinda hate that. It's a really cool looking spot. I thought the image would have turned out great if it would have worked. But the deer rut is starting to die down, so we're going to just change it up and put it on something else. So go ahead and pack this up before it gets too dark, and we'll move it to the next location tomorrow. So you work hard researching best locations, the best lighting setup, the best settings to help tell the story you're wanting to tell. And you can go a couple of hours to weeks, months, even years before you are finally able to create the photograph that you originally set out to get. I like that. The world is so fast-paced, I like slowing down, taking my time, working hard for my photographs. No, you don't always get the photos that you're after, but when you finally do, it makes it all worth it in the end. I would like to say briefly thank you to all that have subscribed to the channel. We hit 3,000 subscribers, which for me is a lot. I'm tickled pink with that number. I am nothing compared to a lot of YouTubers out there, but I think of it, if 3,000 people showed up to my house, that's a lot of people. And doing photography talks, 150, 200 is the most I've ever talked to at one time. So I appreciate everybody that has subscribed to the channel. If you're new here, hit the subscribe button, leave me a comment, tell me what you think. And I love to know where all my viewers are from. So leave me a comment down below where you're from. Give me a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you.